Good afternoon. My name is Jose Ramirez. I graduated in 2010 from the Master in IT. Then I worked in cybersecurity for about 3 years. And last year, I decided just to start working by myself. So we created a company with my partner, Gina. She's here. This afternoon, we intend to put together my expertise in computer vision and her expertise in technology and commercialization of technology to try with some innovations that we're going to speak about now. This is one of the projects, mobile cloud application platform for evaluation of health indicator. Is using computer vision. So, a little more detail. We named our company Ayacua, and it's, it means images in mobile devices can be processed for very useful applications, not only like taking the selfies, but the idea is to support research and also create applications for people that can help in providing diagnostics and facilitate decision making for emergency care. So we explore a very big spectrum of application first, but we have a presentation that can speak better about that. I have some kind of teaser. Next. That is a video from a movie, RoboCop. Oh, I don't know what I press. Need help here. Yeah, this one. Play. I put this, push this button. Yeah, it has some volume.
Can you get audio? 1 second,
everybody. What? It's very slow volume, but it's okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, the revolution begins right now with Detective Alex Murphy.
Okay, so the idea is to, for the public, is to give a context of how we use images. In that case, he's accessing data from a database, and in real time, he's trying to evaluate what is the situation and then identify what to do in that situation. When we come up with ideas, like in the latest presentation, there's a problem. No, we say there's a problem. We try to look the solution. Then we do like a black box. Solve this. In the world right now, probably Most of us here has a mobile device, and we use it for taking pictures. Now our presentation next, I'm gonna tell you some of the ideas that we came up with. Coming next, there's technologies that are being introduced, like the Google Glass or stuff like that is coming. So we're trying to be ahead of that. So, should I give a click? Okay, so I know there's going to be a lot of questions. One of the cases that we explained there was related with the sport that I practice, that is karate. This was a situation in which I got injured, my eye, my nose, and I really didn't have anybody to help me. Unfortunately, emergency equipment or something like that, or personnel or people were no present. And I needed somebody to see my eye, see what it was happening. People in general have idea, but we believe that we are communicated with these mobile devices. But the important thing is also that the remote assistance is possible. So this is part of our ideas that we can implement this kind of applications that either help us using cloud services that can analyze these situations, create also training service for machine learning algorithms to work, support the research of many people that we showed, like MIT and Harvard in medical school. They are working in this kind of stuff. And I think that's it. We are open to questions. We would like maybe to remind you, maybe it was too fast, but we were thinking about mold detection to like have a diagnosis of melanoma, skin cancer that is becoming more common. We also can implement an eye exam with the iPhone, maybe using some lens, like an attachment to the iPhone, and provide this kind of diagnostic. And we have more applications like that. So you have any questions?
Thank you. We have the first question up here.
So it's a two-part question. Who will actually be diagnosing these issues, and what kind of liabilities do you run into from misdiagnosis based on a phone picture through an application?
So in this, on my approach to this kind of innovation is no, is to count with the research that medical school and artificial intelligence is doing. Unfortunately, we all know that there's a disconnection between these inventions and the regulations, you know, like HIPAA or things like that. I know it's very American to think about liabilities because it's the way that we solve conflict. But when we are thinking of the users, no, in this case, this kind of thing is the responsibility of the user. The user are in our model, the user are collaborating with the system. Either legal system is providing data for free for them to train systems, artificial intelligence systems, so they can perform better. We found as example that in these areas of applying computer vision based diagnostics, we are getting only like 75% of accuracy, and but we already thinking about like get rid of false positives, all the same process that you do like in the with any medical device. So liability always gonna exist, but it depends on the agreement, or the disclosure agreement that you do. We're gonna be very careful about that.
Jose, I have two questions. The first is, it's not actually clear to me what your device is. It sounds like a biotelemetry device that also has an algorithm that matches to some kind of diagnosis. Is that what this is?
Yes, it is.
Okay, so then my next question is, how is your device different from the other devices I've seen proposals for? Well, I mean, the ones you've seen proposals for. How is yours different?
No, the device is not different. It's the phone. It's the smartphone. No, we know as example. I have friends that had other startups in artificial intelligence, and right now the approach is that the first robotic device that is or is potential the first robot is this mobile platform that we have. So we want to make this phone like the first artificial intelligence agent that you have access to democratically and with direct access to the resources that are being produced by the research, by the collection of data that the hospitals do. It's kind of opening the doors for a real interaction between the patient and the system to get a fastest response. Like for my incident, I have an incident here. It took me the whole day in the hospital. And at the end, they prescribed me some drug that it wasn't correct. And I had to go to another doctor to see if the prescription was good and fix everything, no? There's no communication. It took me, even my identification, my name is Jose Ramirez. There are 16,000 Jose Ramirez in the US. So no biometrics. So we train to open the doors that the people can participate using the mobile device and also tell when they in a situation either solve it or being smarter about taking decisions. I would gotten better to leave the hospital and go somewhere else.
Quick question. I was looking at trying to figure out where exactly. Oh, sorry, I'm over here.
Oh.
I'm looking to see where exactly you want to, where you want to address the solution. And another quick comment is, just down the street, Professor Ramesh Rajkar, he's at MIT Media Lab. He actually has that device where you can take a quick picture and it does the entire eye exam for you, and he's already passed the regulatory phase. I'm not sure if you know about that. So it's called iNitra, and he has a consecutive one, which is called iMitra, which is addressing the similar problem that you're saying. So if you haven't looked into it, I would definitely recommend it. But the question coming back to it is, which market are you thinking about addressing? Would you want to address it here in the US, or are you thinking developing countries?
That's a good question. I'm aware of the invention of the iNetra. We actually posted in the in there. So my idea it goes to a higher level of abstraction, is that how we can get to every one of you. It doesn't matter where you are in the world. With applications that are being sure that you participate in the whole process of diagnostics, no? And learning from it. The user gonna learn from it, and the system gonna learn from the user. This is maybe utopic, but I think the best innovations has to have this kind of component. We haven't developed like an application like the professor did in MIT yet. But I believe that I can come up with a framework that would take all this and will make the healthcare system more effective. Because I felt it when I have this incident myself that is not working. So I want to make it work, no matter where in the world.
And for our last question.
So what is the underlying technology platform on which the stuff is going to run or is running?
I would like to talk about this when I have like a patent. Okay. But it's an abstraction that is based in the neocortex approaches for solving problems. That's what I'm working on. Yeah.
All right, thank you so much.